my god, the Ottawa Senators could actually do this. They've shot past the expectation of being a playoff doormat for the Rangers or Canadiens. They're going toe-to-toe with a Stanley Cup champion Penguins, for god's sakes. They're going to do it. They made it to OT. They're going to another cup. They... Oh my merciful god!
Shame for this play!
Let this play set the impetus for this upcoming monologue. The Senators have unfortunately been sentenced back to reality after being chucked off a precipice last year. That reality being a struggling mid-tier squad with more holes and questions than it can answer. It's not something that can be identified like finding Waldo, but a myriad of issues that plague the team. Erik Karlsson is playing some of the worst hockey of his career and may be demanding a trade. That imposing forward core is lost and getting nothing done. And the feel-good story of Craig Anderson has taken a massive turn for the worse. Everything has been stabbed 20 times like Caesar. The sudden boom under Guy Boucher seems to have been a fluke. The constant mockery of the 1-3-1 in hockey circles and forums everywhere is getting far more reinforcement. The so-called Kanata Wall has crumbled and fallen like the one in Berlin. Even after 1 year, it appears that the stereotypical Bond villain has overstayed his welcome. It's not at all because the 1-3-1 is an incredibly demanding scheme that is easy to pick apart when every piece is not at optimal performance. It requires speed, awareness, and a blazingly quick counterattack. Just like in Tampa Bay, Guy Boucher may have worn out the sense. He has learned nothing. This can also be stated with Air GM Pierre Dorion, whom took the reins after Brian Murray retired a few years ago. I would make a prediction about where he will go, but I traded that future just like Dorion for immediate relief. It really reared its ugly head last season, when he overpaid Vancouver and gave them a good prospect in Jonathan Dolan for a declining Alex Burrows. Let me reiterate, this guy got fleeced in a trade by Jim Benning. It didn't just end there either. The promise of shoring up the top six and replacing Mark Mathod in the offseason was of critical importance to Ottawa. Dorion shat his pants and did nothing. Until recently. It has finally happened, boys. Matt Duchene is finally free. No longer will he be completely miserable and discontent in the hell of Colorado. He will be the slight upgrade to Kyle Turris that this team desperately needs. All it cost Ottawa was their first round selection from this year, next year's first round pick, another draft pick, and the Hamburglar to shed salary. Dorion, how the fuck did you make the bumbling Joe Sakic look like a genius? The man had absolutely no leverage and you still gave him the haul he desired. Even worse, the trade has backfired in the worst conceivable way. Kyle Turris is performing well in Nashville and has become an important cog in their machine. What has Duchene done since going to Ottawa? Shit his pants and done all but nothing. By god, it's almost as if Matt Duchene is massively overrated and can't carry a line or a team as he was hyped to do. In fact, we can almost say that Pierre Dorion destroyed the team chemistry by taking away a key piece in Turris for a high-risk gamble. It has not worked at all. And Duchene is complaining about why he keeps getting compared to Kyle Turris? I wonder why. This year has been a disaster for them so far, but this is sadly far from the main issue with the team. The real elephant in the room is Eugene Melnyk. Fucking Melnyk, a sniveling, spineless little shit who could give as few fucks about the goodwill towards a city as you could imagine. I could go on and on about his histrionics, his eccentricities, the way he's utterly embarrassed the city he's supposed to represent, but for this, I'm going to bring about a more recent example. Harken back to December 16th, 2017, a time of celebration for the Senators franchise. They were on the eve of hosting their first ever outdoor game, and the eyes of the NHL were on Ottawa. Normally, an owner would use this time to promote the team in the city they play for, but not our old fuckwit Eugene. Let's first start by chucking the fanbase under the entire transit system for not showing up to games. Sure, we all had a hearty laugh at the Sens being unable to sell out playoff games last season, but there's asterisks. Primarily, the fact that the stadium is located in a western suburb that is inaccessible by public transport and is a nightmare to navigate by car. Secondly, prices are exorbitant. Eugene has been bleeding the fans dry for years now. Even to goddamn park, it costs an Ottawan his or her soul. Third, Sens fans despise Melnyk, like literally want him Mussolini'd in front of Ottawa's municipal buildings as soon as humanly possible. I mean, this is hyperbole, you say. How can a city hate a man that fails to properly market his franchise, force the greatest player in their team's history to retire in a different uniform by fucking up contract negotiations, consistently keeps costs as low as possible for the sake of profits, and cries wolf to try and get a new stadium to get all of those big boy bucks. People love that sort of thing. The big city is sure to fix your attendance woes. Look at the adulation that he gets for threatening to relocate them right before their fucking team alumni game. Do you have any tact? Oh right, you don't. You're a petty, self-indulgent charlatan who cares for nothing more than his wallet. This city gave you a fucking liver to extend your life, and this is how you repay them? Remember that casino you lost out on? Remember how much of a bitch fit you threw at the city of Ottawa for not bending over to your will? Why should they care about you? You're not a citizen, you live in fucking Barbados to escape Canadian tax regulations. Eugene truly needs to be triggered by Russians and more journalists that call him out for his bullshit. That will improve his goodwill in the city, just like the senators themselves. A team crumbling from the inside out. From the absolute highs of their playoff run to this on-ice abortion, the team represents the owner that dangles them like a marionette. A hollow shell, a lifeless lump, forced to move by the lust of currency. In the end, it will most likely conclude with the city giving in to this bastard's demands, or him packing their bags and moving to a city that will somehow tolerate his bullshit. Eugene is not going to be selling anytime soon, and all sides seem to be at an impasse. I personally find it funny how Melnick bitches about how Russia unfairly treated Ukrainians for generations, but he's doing the same goddamn thing. Either way, Melnick does not like to lose. Let us hope that he continues to do so for the sake of Ottawa.
I think with the lack of stoppages here in this second... Oh, it's lost by Phillips and into the net! My goodness!